welcome back to another episode of Surviving Mars. We are playing in the Grinnell Dome. This is actually going to be our last episode of this series, as the new expansion for Surviving Mars, Space Race, comes out on the 15th. And we will be starting up a new series using that expansion. It changes the game pretty significantly, so it really doesn't make sense for me to just continue playing from here. And I'm not even sure we can. So currently we have a crop problem. Domes. Alright, got a rocket that's ready to launch, but it hasn't picked up enough stuff yet. Got a new anomaly analyzed. Sustainable architecture. Okay. Compact passenger module. Low G engineering, so we can get the medium sized dome, would be nice. We need to build, excuse me, a large water tank. Research, 3D machining. Deep water extraction. Okay. Alright, so we do have that.
Resources are low.
Let's go ahead and build ourselves a large water tank. Let's. Okay, so our plan was to do it over here. That needs power, but we're going to go ahead and run a line. Out to it. Okay, we've got our resources going in.
Research complete.
3D machining is done. So let's go ahead and subsurface heating. Really need it, but we'll see what it unlocks. Concrete.
Sector scanned.
What kind of sectors we got left? Okay. There goes our large water tank. We'll see how the St. Elmo's fire likes that. Capacity 1,000. Stored water 1,000. You know, if we build a second one. We can start getting rid of some of these other water tanks that are around here. Maybe just have one per dome. That would help lower our maintenance costs. Okay. Alright, so that is our second water tank. Alright, so let's start getting rid of some of these.
Meteor shower incoming.
We just don't need them. We use those big tanks. All right, so we can also get rid of some of these. These water tanks here. I don't think it's a bad idea to have like a water tank near each dome. We just don't really need to have like tons of them laying around everywhere. So we've got two large water tanks. We're starting to clean up and get rid of some of these excess water tanks. I think we can use some more water, use another water extractor. Get rid of these water tanks, I think. Get rid of most of them anyway. These are oxygen tanks.
Sector scanned.
There. Hoping to lower our maintenance costs. And these three tanks go for these three guys. Rocket back home. Making residential slots. 58. Do a passenger rocket. Review. Botanist, scientist. Engineer, engineer, botanist. Can bring in 32 people. Here. experiment. Okay, so we get this experiment going. 70% progress. Research lab, 720. Okay, nice. Okay. How are we doing on tech? Okay. I'd like for us to have something that we can do with rubber printing. We do have 3D printing, so we can build our own machine parts factories.
Research complete.
Okay. All right, so we finished that. We got compact hangers. Overprinting, deep water extraction. I think deep water extraction is going to be important. Okay. To know what we can actually make. Okay, so these things have no deposits.
You're listening to the Red Frontier with me, Kim Taihee. We supply an endless hit parade of musical home runs.
Alright, so we can go ahead and get rid of these. Build a new one. Over here. Get some power to it. So I think we can get rid of this, and this. All right. Oh, we got this rocket here. Ready to go down. That rocket will go ahead and launch when it's full. And food.
Milestone achieved. New colonists have arrived.
Surface heater. Let's go ahead and build a farm in here. Second one over here. Okay, so we got that. The dome's coming over here. basic game dome. Be nice. Trigon dome. Okay. Awaiting final results.
Sector scanned.
Ow.
Time flies. The day of the final mission evaluation is drawing near.
Yeah.
It's probably a good time to look at the colony statistics and address any goals and issues that we haven't so far.
All right, well, maybe we can pick some low-level ones here.
No active research.
Do some outsourcing.
In a vivid display of unearthly beauty, a surge in wisp activity far surpassing our most optimistic expectations played out before our eyes.
Infinite ability to determine the age of indoor lights, to find the behavioral patterns. Okay, the water tank succeeded in ranging from the ability to determine the age of the individual lights, to finding behavioral patterns unique to some but absent to others. Our scientists are eager to get sorting through the treasure trove of data. Will-O-Wisp tech is available. Okay. What is Will-O-Wisp tech? At you. Light trap. Okay. Let's go ahead and put a statue somewhere.
This is Kim Tae-hee, and you're listening to the Red Frontier.
Now,
I'll tell you
tech.
About a true passion okay. of mine, besides baseball, that is. Beer. Did you know that China, where I originally come from, is the biggest beer-producing nation on Earth? Let's play the next song.
Okay, so we're going to work on getting some research to go after some deep core stuff. Alright, so machine parts and polymers becoming a problem.
Research complete.
I think we only need like 3 techs, maybe. Do we do any more outsourcing? Machine parts. Space machine parts. Okay.
Crop failure reported.
That's not good. Earth Marsh Initiative Explorers. Okay, so we are going to send this rocket home. And this one home as well. Because we need to bring in some stuff. Hoping that we can get all the techs that we need. Started dumping resources, okay. 13 buildings not working. Vacant residential slots, 30. So we could bring in another group of passengers. We may want to fairly soon. And it's a light show.
Research complete.
Okay. Atomic accumulator. Draining water.
Sector scanned.
There we go. Sectors continuing to go out. Yeah, so we don't have a deep water source yet, but we definitely have some deep metals and stuff. Rockets are almost home. Make it residential.
Funding received.
Okay. So let's plan on a passenger rocket. And then we will do a cargo rocket. That isn't much. Bringing in more people. Let's see, what do we got for? Martian University. We should probably think about doing that. Oh, that one's close. And then, playground. And residential space, 12.
Crop failure reported.
That is not good. So we got two rockets coming back. All kinds of seeing fire going on. Physics. Institute. Renegades stolen from Grinnell Dome C.
Research complete.
Okay. That battery optimization. We're just gonna start collecting these lower techs here. Get everything up. Martian Institute of Science. Martian Patents. Emergency Training.
You're listening to Dust the Red Frontier with Kim Tae-hee. The good thing about our music is that when it hits you, you feel no pain.
So I think overall we have become kind of, I want to say that we've become self-sufficient as a colony. I am bringing more people in and out so that we can get our workforce up to speed. I think overall we're in pretty good shape.
New colonists have arrived.
Okay. So we got our colonists. People moving in. Hopefully they will take up some nice jobs. Definitely need a water source or a water extraction fixed. We're going to play through to our evaluation. We've got six souls left. Building's not working. Eight. So I think I want to put another machine parts factory in here. Got an electronics factory. A lot of slots open in that one. Nobody seems to want to work there.
Sector scanned. Anomaly found.
Be nice if we can build a bigger. We need more domes, or we need bigger domes so we can start replacing these smaller ones. Martian-born adept ability. graduate faster universities and turn to higher chance. Okay. Dome bioscaping. Basic domes, micro domes, brown domes have improved comfort. General training, colonists without suffer a lower work penalty. Okay.
Research complete.
There we go. We'll start with that. There comes all of the will-o'-wisps.
Anomaly analyzed.
That certainly helps our research. So I think we've made the tech. I think we've gotten the number of techs we needed. These guys sure like our water tanks. So we're gonna turn that on so these guys can start going back and forth once they get full. Martian days consist of nearly 25 Earth hours.
Crop failure reported.
Another one. That's starting to get a little ridiculous. We do have.
Research complete.
Research completed. We are working on the Will-O-Wisp mystery. Four more swords. Mind getting the will-o'-wisp tech up and running before the evaluation happens. VR workshop. Nice. Ooh, necrology. Research acrology. Behavioral shaping. Sanatorium. necrology.
My name is Kim, and you are listening to the Red Frontier, your heavy-hitting musical station for the whole Red Martian Nation.
High-powered jets. Polymers production, 7 polymers. Maintenance, 2.9. Upgrade construction, 3 of 8. Electronics. Okay. Still use more people.
Sector scanned.
Yeah. Okay, we add a new sector. Alright, so currently we're just waiting for the clock to run down so we can get our evaluation and see what kind of score we get. Kind of maintain things as we go along. 131. It'd be nice if we could find a way to get rid of these. I don't like them. Empty building's not working.
Research complete.
Will-O-Wisp.
Our science team has been working tirelessly to design this new miracle of engineering, the light trap.
Water is the actual light trap, even in trapped inside us. Quite eager to try the prototype. Construct a light trap. Okay. So we need a little bit of concrete, we need some polymers, and we need some electronics. Electronics could be a problem. Have a whole lot in the way of electronics. Okay, we got our concrete and our polymers. You have 2 electronics constructed. and carrying them over here. Come on, we just need a little bit of electronics. Can we do some electronics storage over here? And have this highly desirable? We're at 98 souls. We're almost finished. I could spill it out with ores. Priority to get it done.
Sector scanned.
With the electronics. Will-O-Wisp still going, plugging away. And we are heading into our last soul. Looks like we may not get enough electronics to finish that off. Unfortunate, but it is the way it is. Aren't producing them fast enough. I would say at this point the colony is self-sufficient. We have oxygen, we have water, we're still losing people occasionally, so our numbers are going down a little bit. We can always bring in more colonists. As our tech improves, we should be able to get our comfort level up so that we can start generating Martian-born.
Welcome back.
Better.
You're listening to the Red Frontier radio station with Kim Taihi. We have a message from Devin. Hey, Kim. I just want to invite you and all your listeners to the first virtual Martian beer symposium.
Milestone achieved.
And there is...
The mission evaluation period is over, and the results of our efforts are visible. A steady track of technological milestones can be traced back to the moment the very first rocket landed on the Red Planet.
Even people back on Earth can join us.
All right, the colony has proven its worth as a cradle of scientific thought, and everyone is sure that the future is hiding more secrets to be uncovered and more mysteries solved. Mission evaluation objective completed. You have 43 research technologies out of a target of 40. Final score, 5,483.
Count me.
And there you have it, folks.
We need more initiatives like this. To celebrate this wonderful idea,
we have a milestone. So we did it. 100 colonists, Evaluation, soul 100, so we did that. There's our score, 23,539. So as I said at the beginning of this episode, we're going to close out this series. Next week we will be starting a new one. We're using the Space Race expansion. If you liked the video, please hit the like button. If you'd like to see more, hit the subscribe button. And until next time, my name has been Amradorn, and you have a good one. Goodbye.